Welcome. Myself, Velumani, working as Assistant Professor in the Department of Civil Engineering, Komaraj College of Engineering and Technology. In this lecture, I am going to discuss about the behavior of rectangular RC beams in shear. Generally, beam is a main part of a structure which carries the external load, comes from the slab and transfers the loads to the column. So, the shear force is the force acting in the beam perpendicular to the longitudinal axis. So, this is the generally maximum at the support or below the concentrated load acting on the beam. So, here some of the examples given for the beam carrying a point load at midpoint, the shear force diagram will be like this. And likewise, for other cases like simply supported beam with UDL and UVL also given here. Here you can see one of the test setup of a beam. Here 2-point load is acting on the beam. So, you can clearly see the shear crack occurring on the beam. So, this is the beam where the vertical reinforcement is called shear reinforcement. So, the shear reinforcement is the important one to carry or to transfer the load and to avoid the cracks on the beam. So, to calculate the shear force acting on the beam or shear stresses, there are some of the formulas available in the IS code and also some tables are there like table 19 and 20 from IS 456 2000. Table 19 gives the design shear strength of concrete, that is tau c values, and table 20 maximum shear stress tau c max. These two tables are available in the IS 456 2000 code. So, the design for shear reinforcement as per class 40.1 from IS 456 2000. So, the maximum shear force in the beam is found based on the loading condition of the beam. So, which has the significant significance? The first one is nominal shear stress, that is tau v, can be calculated by using the formula tau v equal to vu by bd. So, this formula is available in IS 456 in the class 40.1. Likewise, the shear strength that can be taken by concrete based on the grade of the concrete, that is FCK value and the percentage of steel. Okay. So, the next one, the design shear stress, that is tau c value, this value can be taken from the table 19 which I have shown in the previous slide. And for to take the value from the table 19, we need percentage of steel. So, the percentage of steel can be calculated by 100 AST divided by BD, where AST is the area of steel reinforcement and B and D are the cross section of the beam. And the third one, maximum design shear stress, that is tau c max, which is in table 20. By having all these three value, we can compare the values, then we can decide whether the shear reinforcement is required or not. Now, there are some cases. Let us see the first case, that is if tau v is less than tau c, that is nominal shear stress is less than design shear stress, then there is no need to provide shear reinforcement. However, a minimum shear reinforcement should be provided as per IS codal provision. For that, the spacing of the shear reinforcement can be find out by using the formula 0.87 Fy ASV by 0.4 into B, where ASV is the area of shear reinforcement. Here you can see ASV formula, that is N into pi diameter squared by 4, where N is the number of leg we are providing. The second case is if tau V greater than tau C but less than tau C max. Here the design shear reinforcement is required. However, minimum shear reinforcement as per class 26.5.1.6, the formula is available, SVE is 0.87 FY ASV into D divided by VUS. Here VUS is the vertical stirrup that we can provide it by for the all the beams. The VUS can be calculated by using the formula VUS equal to VU minus tau Z into BD. And the third case, the last case, tau V is greater than tau C max. If tau V exceeds the maximum shear stress, then we need to redesign the section. And the maximum spacing of the shear reinforcement should be less than or equal to 0.75 times of the D value, effective depth of the section, or else thickets maximum 300 mm, whichever is lesser. Let us see one example. Here the design, the question is, design the shear reinforcement for a RC beam subjected to a maximum factored shear force of 46.6 kilonewton with longitudinal tension reinforcement of 3.93%. The size of the beam is given as 200 mm by 350 mm effective, and the grade of concrete and grade of steel also given. Here you can see the shear force value and the percentage of steel reinforcement is directly given in the problem itself. So, as I said, the first step is finding the nominal shear stress. So, the nominal shear stress formula tau V is Vu by Bd. By substituting all the values, that is Vu, B and D, we are getting some 0.667 Newton per mm square as nominal shear stress. Now, we have to take the tau C value from table 19 from IS 456-2000. So, here for M20 grade concrete and the percentage of steel reinforcement is 3.93%. You can see from table 19 for M20 grade concrete and percentage of steel reinforcement for 3 and above, the design shear stress value is 0.82. So, we can take this value as design shear stress, that is 0.82 Newton per mm square. The third one, maximum design shear stress, that is tau C max from table 20 for M20 grade concrete, this value is 2.8 Newton per mm square. Now, we are going to compare all these three, then we will decide whether the shear reinforcement is required or not. Now, you can see here the tau V value is less than tau C. So, no shear reinforcement is required. So, without providing shear reinforcement, the longitudinal bars will not be stand in the beam. So, that we need to provide minimum shear reinforcement as per the requirement from IS 456-2000. So, the spacing of the beam can be find out by using the formula as I said earlier, and the area of steel reinforcement by finding all these value, we can provide, we can find spacing of shear reinforcement. Here I am getting 453.56 mm. So, we need to check whether this spacing is allowed or not. As I said earlier, we there are steps to find the spacing. So, spacing should be less than or equal to 0.75 times D, or else 300 mm, whichever is lesser. So, by calculating SV value, here I am getting 262 mm, but the calculated value of SV is 453.56 mm. So, we need to provide less than 262 mm as the spacing of the shear reinforcement, so that we can decide the shear reinforcement spacing as 260 mm. So, we can assume, or we can provide two legged bars, and here I am assuming 8 mm dia bars, so that two legged 8 mm dia bars at 260 mm center to center can be provided. Here you can see in the figure the breadth of the beam, depth of the beam, overall depth of the beam, and the shear reinforcement details are given. Let us see another example. The question is, design the shear reinforcement for a RC beam of effective span 8 meter subjected to a superimposed load of 35 kilonewton per meter with a tension steel of 1.22%. So, the size of the beam given as 300 mm by 700 mm and concrete grade and steel grade also given. So, here you can see the percentage of steel as 1.22% and superimposed load, that is live load of the beam is given. So, we need to find the total load of the beam, then only we can find the shear force values. For that, we need to find self weight of the beam first. So, the self weight of the beam is nothing but area, that is cross sectional area into unit weight of the concrete. The unit weight of the concrete, we all know that 25 kilonewton per meter cube. So, by multiplying breadth, depth and unit weight of concrete, we can get the self weight of the beam. Then live load is given as 35 and it should be multiplied with 1.5 to convert it into factored load, and the total load acting on the beam is some 60.375 kilonewton per meter. Now, we can find the maximum shear force. We are taking this as a UDL, that is uniformly distributed load, since we are getting all the loads in kilonewton per meter. So, the shear force formula will be WL by 2. So, VU value, I am getting some 241.5 kilonewton. Now, as said in the previous problem, we are going to find all the three shear stresses. First one, nominal shear stress, that is tau V. Here, the tau V value is 1.24 newton per mm square. Then the design shear stress from table 19, as I said earlier, percentage of steel here is 1.22%. We have to take the appropriate value from the table 19. So, the for M20 grade concrete and tau C value is 0.664 newton per mm square. And the third one, maximum design shear stress, tau C max from table 20, that is 2.8 newton per mm square. So, by comparing all these three, that is tau, we are getting some tau V is greater than tau C but less than tau C max, hence shear reinforcement is required. Now, we can use the formula SV is equal to 0.87 FY ASV into D divided by VUS, and VUS is nothing but for vertical stirrup. And area of shear reinforcement N into pi diameter squared by F4. So, after finding, I am getting some 210.6 mm as spacing, and we know the limitations of spacing also, that is 0.75 into D and 300 mm. Here I am getting 487.5 mm, that is 0.75 D value, but the calculated value of SV is 210.6 mm only. So, we can take 210 mm as the spacing of the stirrups. So, in the diagram, we should mention all the details, the breadth of the beam, effective depth of the beam, overall depth of the beam and the legs, also the diameter of the stirrups, all these things. So, finally, write the results, that is provide 2-legged 8 mm dia at 210 mm center to center stirrups. Thank you.